We know that we can determine an empirical formula from mass percent data. But in order to determine a molecular formula, we have to have one more piece of information. We must know the molecular weight of the compound. So first, we determine the empirical formula, and then, using the empirical formula, we can figure out the molecular formula. Since we have percentage, we will assume that we have 100 grams of the compound so that we can convert those percentages into mass. Our compound will contain 75.46 grams of carbon, 4.43 grams of hydrogen, and 20.10 grams of oxygen. Next, we will convert the mass of each element into moles using the molar mass that comes from the periodic table. The molar mass of carbon is 12.01 grams per mole, so we end up with 6.283 moles of carbon. The molar mass of hydrogen is 1 gram per mole, so we have 4.43 moles of hydrogen. And the molar mass of oxygen is 16 grams per mole, and that gives us 1.256 moles of oxygen. To get our empirical formula, we divide by the smallest number of moles. Looking at our data, we see that 1.256 moles is the smallest, and so we will divide everything by 1.256. And that gives us 5 carbon and 3.5 hydrogen and 1 oxygen. We know that empirical formulas can only contain whole numbers, and so let's multiply by something to get rid of the 3.5. We multiply by 2, that keeps the ratio the same. It gives me 10 carbon, 7 hydrogen, and 2 oxygen. So our empirical formula is C10H7O2. Now that we have our empirical formula, we can use the molecular weight information given in the problem to determine the molecular formula. Let's first calculate the molecular weight of our empirical formula. We have 10 carbon, and we know the molar mass is 12.01 grams per mole. We have 7 hydrogen, each is 1 gram per mole. And 2 oxygen, each 16 grams per mole. And this tells us our empirical formula has a molar mass of 159.1 grams per mole. The problem tells us that the molecular weight of our compound is 318.31 grams per mole. If the mass of the empirical formula and the molecular formula were equal, then our empirical formula is the molecular formula of the compound. In this case, they are not equal. Let's take the molecular weight given in the problem. We know that's the weight of the formula, 318.31 grams per mole, and divide by the molecular weight of the empirical formula, which we calculated is 159.1 grams per mole. And we get 2. This tells us that our molecular formula is 2 times the empirical formula. So our molecular formula is C20H14O4.